back.
Yeah. Alright, so what do you do now? The rope hits the ground.
Right. D-plane.
Right. May now D-plane.
May now disembark.
We're all going down. Ranger cleric first.
Okay.
Which one of you is going down the rope first?
I will.
Okay. So as you hit the ground...
Is this your favorite terrain type? Rope?
Forest.
Forest is my favorite.
Forest, then you are in your favorite terrain type of forest.
So you have advantage on survival rolls?
Survival rolls. He can move stealthily at a normal speed with the group.
Yeah.
Group can't be ambushed. Group can't be lost by magical means. You can't tell I play a ranger.
See, that's why you make swamp your favorite terrain. Because if you... Or basically anything with...
horrible move,
difficult
yeah,
terrain.
Naturally.
Because
yeah.
It overrides that. Druids do it naturally all the time.
Nothing's
so we can't get ambushed.
I mean, they are.
So we can't get ambushed?
OP as fuck.
I mean, as long as you tell
as long as you're awake, yes.
I can't be ambushed. That's what alert does.
Basically, your favorite terrain gives you the alert perk for free on that.
Oh.
The only thing it doesn't do is give you the initiative bonus. Everything
plus
else,
five.
You can't be surprised.
That'd be awesome.
You can't be lost except
I probably
by
shoot
magic means, so you take, like, someone
yeah,
magic maze, you know.
Settle down. Let's not get ahead of yourself.
Otherwise, you know exactly where you're going.
It's a plus 12.
And you can try
my
weapon
plus
12. Move up 24 hours. Correct.
So we're going to roll.
So,
who went first?
All right, as you step down, out walks, for lack of a better term, a squid with a...
Is it just me down there?
Yeah,
down.
They're coming. The rest of them are coming down, but since you're the first, he's greeting you first.
Hello.
You're shorter than I thought.
Thank you.
Excuse you.
You're welcome.
Who did you think that was?
He's almost as tall as the fox.
Fuck you.
At least the fox is more used to.
None of us
are
down there yet.
I'm just kidding.
As he's saying, he's like...
Ignore
and,
the short
and
one.
I
I'll finish her later.
Oh, so you're down. Alright, so that means you two are down then. Are you two on your way?
Are you telling the lich to fuck
off?
I could choke it, make it a newt.
But hang on.
Can I hear this from where I am on the road?
Yeah, as you're going down, yeah.
What do you mean?
Oh, why?
What are you doing?
I don't know how far away everything was.
Alright, you're maybe from where you are to where Kirby is talking to.
Okay, no, he's wondering how far I am away
from
the
rope.
Rope.
Oh, from the rope? Yeah.
So maybe 5, 10
feet?
Yeah,
the rope would be in the corner of the room.
Okay, so then the last, like, 10 feet of rope, I jump off and hit him on the head as I come down.
Sorry about that.
Ah!
Bad.
Oh, this one is your slave, is it?
There's a debt to be paid.
Ah. We call that a slave. Indentured servant, whatever. Alright, so you're all down here now at this point after that little show. Ernest has told me you are here about my problem.
Yeah, what is it?
Well, I take you all are familiar with a lich, as I am.
A lich, yes. A mind flare, a lich, no.
We've
you're a lich?
We've encountered them.
I admire you for not seeing race or ethnicity or anything, but that's your well, dumb.
Everyone bleeds the same.
You're
except oozes.
Actually, Dragonborn. No.
Educate this one.
We'll do it later.
I just got hit on the head, right? I just got hit on the head. I'm good.
Should have hit you harder.
It'll come back eventually.
You hope.
Probably not.
Yes. Well, the problem I had back in before this sage showed me the error of my ways, as it were. I was amassing.
I feel you, brother.
An army.
Wow.
And the army has been taken. A paladin is set to get rid of me.
Set to get rid of the army?
Me.
Oh,
with
get
my
rid
army.
Of you. Oh, with your army.
I had raised an army of the undead as, to correct the errors of society. The sage.
Point of order?
Yes.
This paladin took over an army of undead?
And it didn't say he was a good paladin. Mm.
It's unholy paladin.
Yeah, okay. This might be an okay mission for us then.
Yeah, sounds good.
This mission looks better and better.
Yeah.
I dig it.
Next.
I judge all the missions based on the amount of guilt I feel afterwards. So.
The amount of guilt.
Yeah.
Well,
I
went to the entire orphanage
wait,
and
what's that
and
smell?
They were all mind flayers.
Oh, it's not good.
It's like a wash right there.
Almost everything's good. Everything's good.
Path.
I woke up this morning. That's good. Well, as he has taken my army, he intends to march against me and God knows what else. Or
what, and come and show up here?
Here somewhere. I don't think he's quite ascertained my location yet, but I'm more concerned with what he's going to do in the meantime to draw me out if he can't find me. There are nearby population centers,
well,
as you call them.
Well, I tell you what. Do you know where he's at? Do you know where your army's at?
I do not know where my army is. I believe he's storing it in another dimension.
That's good.
Yeah. As for him, he has been hard to track.
Can you scry?
Not for him. Whoever is protecting him, whatever arcane force is, stronger than me. Stronger than the Sage.
So he might not be alone?
You know, I mean, he's probably evil, bad dude. Probably got a god that has his back.
Blind, do you walk?
We could be fighting a god, guys.
Go for a walk.
Yeah,
Kajal will be proud.
Let's just go back to Florin.
Let's hope it's not Kajal.
No.
That'd be crazy.
No. You notice Kajal's the only one that can get to the Sagittan field.
Is there a two-sided to Kajal? Like, good side, evil side?
Yeah, it's called Kajal.
But you know.
There is a way you might be able to track.
Yeah, I'm pretty confident.
Okay. I'm elf ears.
You're elf ears?
I'm not all ears. That would be the gnome.
Yeah,
also
I
call
some awesome. People say it can fly. They're wrong. I tried.
Yeah. But he grabbed the rope on the way down.
They pushed me off, and I was like,
bad rolls, man. Bad rolls. Awesome bosses.
No, that was a pretty good roll.
BAM! Bitches!
Yes. Just fucking wasted it, son.
Nah.
His ears start flapping and he flies.
Holy fuck. Never a waste.
Guys!
And Basil's dead.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, I got something for this.
I'm going back to the boat.
Okay.
I'm going back to the boat.
Trick shot, wings. This will drop him 20 feet.
That'll keep him in place.
Yeah. Okay.
There are two places that might be able to find him. Unless you all know of a greater being. A greater god who is more powerful than the one hiding him. I don't know who is hiding him.
I'm not going to engage.
Mm-hmm.
You can either go to Stanlow or Fort Loon. Each of them have a powerful... He points them out on your map. I am a quest giver. I have a map.
So we go to Stanlow, which is like 5 miles. Or we can go to
both
Fort.
Both of them have...
Where's Fort Loon?
It's all other continent.
Other continent across
all the way at the bottom.
And it's FTL.
Okay, so we see how much... what's the distance between...
The distance between two continents is about... You see where Driftwood is?
Like, from that east coast to that west coast is about
the same?
It's about
the distance where Driftwood is.
Okay.
From between Fort Loon and Grap Keep.
So
I just enlarged. Yeah, I enlarged the other continent to make.
So we can totally.
No wonder for a while.
Yeah, sorry.
We can totally just make a stop.
This is a much better representation.
My boat only goes in one direction.
Those are your best bets for military, unless, of course, like I said, you know a greater being you can find through your scrying.
Okay.
I can provide you a scroll.
I know a pretty badass great being. Well, I don't know. He does. You met, right? Shot shit with your god? You're tight, right?
Wow, that's a good
one.
Yeah,
he is.
That's a good one. I don't...
Roll for history check.
I don't know.
I mean, you got, like, initiated and stuff, right?
I mean, yeah.
He presided over your Sunday schools?
Yeah. Well, I mean, whether he was actually there or if it was...
Well, isn't he everywhere?
Well, yeah, that's the thing. Well, that would be a 6.
Yeah, you did though. I rolled a 1, so.
Oh.
No matter what you roll.
You, in one of your early trainings.
Me. It's like, I don't need to roll a 20 all the time.
You can save them.
Wow.
You ready for backstory?
Yeah.
All right,
let's Will, catch up. Yeah, sit down for this. This ought to be good.
I'm listening. All right. Early in your training as a cleric to worship the god of Kajal, or whatever he refers to himself as, I will let you choose as your former character.
The Master of Poison
Sumac. Official title.
Yes.
It's up to you.
You guys keep saying Master of Poison Sumac.
Yeah.
He was the Master of Poison Sumac, so perhaps he is a Grand Master of Poison Sumac.
Just put
well,
it
he
out
would
there.
Be.
The
Grand
Poison
Surveyor
Sumac.
Of all of this and that.
I like that title.
That's good. That's right here.
That's a crit roll ripoff.
That's fine. That's good.
That was good. That's good. All right. So early in your initiation,
write that down.
What was it again?
The Grand Surveyor of all of this and that.
Okay, here we go.
Hold on.
That was a
character sheet. Master of Poison Sumac, the Grand Surveyor of this and that.
Survey.
Oh,
fuck. So,
but keep going. I'm listening.
That means he sees all.
That's right.
At least he likes to say he does. So, it was.
He sees all inside of a woman's brothel. All
right.
Wow. And the bottom of every keg of ale.
Woo! Alright, as you were going through initiation early on, during one of your vision ceremonies of praying to Kajal, a great light enveloped you and you were brought forth and disappeared for no more than a minute, but came back having told tales of speaking with Kajal. Most didn't believe you, but this didn't occur.
Did I have ale on the breath?
Oh, you did.
That's the only way you got in.
Yeah.
You also came back speaking of another world where Kajal was working with a group of people to save some dimensional plane or other world from something. That's all.
Deja
was there a pretty badass rogue?
No.
Unlikely.
There's a girl in the skirt, though.
Nothing that was mentioned.
Nothing that was mentioned.
No badass rogue, just a girl in a skirt.
Yeah.
It's not a girl. You sure about that?
But yes, you were. From then on, referred to as anointed by the Holy Order. And thus have been
now
referred
see,
to.
So we got an in.
This makes me think of Dragonlance. The there was Paladin was the lawful good god. Tiamat is the chaotic evil god.
Okay.
Paladin would walk with the humans every now and then. He would take on this persona of Fizban the Fabulous. And
I know these names. Never played the game.
Oh, it was awesome.
I remember.
Is Tiamat like a dragon god?
Yeah. So is Paladin. Yeah. Paladin is the platinum dragon.
The Dragonlance.
Yes.
Well, that makes sense now.
And Fizban, you could encounter him picture Gandalf looking guy out of Lord of the Rings.
Yeah.
But like weird. And like these butterflies, red butterflies that were flying around.
Yeah.
They were the gold dragon protectors that were. Okay. So there was like five or
this
ten.
Have you seen The Hobbit?
It's a lot.
The druid wizard guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, Radagast.
Gandalf, but weird.
Yeah, a lot like
Radagast
that.
The one who was in charge of the forest. So
yep.
The druid.
Yeah.
And only seen in the latest Hobbit, and then nowhere else.
But yeah, that reminds me of there was talk of
that's
a couple of hooks for NPC quests. They're like, there's a god who was immortal, walked amongst humans, forgot he was a god, he needed help to remember. Stuff like that.
That's going to be the Thor Ragnarok.
Yeah.
Sort of.
But there were a bunch of them, and it mentioned stuff like that, because it made mention to Dragonlance and a couple
that's
other where they pulled them from.
That
they
was
said, where did you get these from?
Such
were,
an awesome
world.
That was back second edition. Stuff. This was.
There was a lot of actually. I was on behind the screen recently. 2E has come up a lot recently.
Yeah.
It's been. I don't know if
Larry Elmore did all the artwork in the book.
Yeah.
Really good. Tracy Weiss and Margaret Hickman wrote the books, The Dragonlance Chronicles.
Okay. There's been a lot of references to them. I don't know if it had better. Because I've heard multiple things on behind the screen, Reddit behind the screen about. Which one had better modules to integrate versus rules? This is always seems to be that argument.
Oh, in second edition. Yeah, well, there was
second edition of 3.5 from a block with modules being better, but rules mechanically not being as refined.
Yeah.
So,
well, Dragonlance gave you a lot of neat stuff. There was the Knights of Salamnia. There was the Knights of the Rose. The Knights of
Yeah.
And there were two other orders of knights.
Say about, like, that one came up, what's the other one? Matt Kilgall talks about one of them.
Mounted dragon lances and footman lances. A mounted dragon lance, if you jousted, you would, the damage that you would do, you added your hit point pool to the damage, and you added your dragon's hit point pool to the damage.
Sing!
Lift.
Yeah, it was disgusting.
I'm trying to remember what the
smoke break.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah.
Tangent.
I know, I'm trying to remember what Matt Coville's one is that he constantly mentions that he runs. Because there's a couple modules and he talks about how he swapped characters out from 2-1 from 2-D. Yes, he went on the deck without you?
Yeah, so the Fizban the Fabulous encounter. That was how I always pictured meeting deities. I always thought that was
cool. Out of game, you do realize what's happening.
Oh yeah, this is the tie-in.
Yeah, this is the beginning of the tie-in.
Yeah.
Yay, tie-ins.
Hey, you gonna want more of this?
No, the tie-in's been going on. When he mentioned something, I didn't fall from the ceiling. You're so calm. And the stream is back up, I think. Is anyone watching?
It looked like it was on Kirby's phone.
Okay.
Yep.
Here, I'll really mess with
you. Here, I'll roll that history check of 15 to know about the lore of Dragonlance.
Here you go. I'm tempted to mute it and explain what's going on.
Just so you don't spoil it for everybody else.
Yeah.
So, what I picture is, what was that Jodie Foster movie where, was it Contact?
Where she's sitting on the hood of the car with the earphones?
Yeah, and they build this sphere, they drop it, she's in it.
Oh, yeah.
And it drops for 17 seconds.
Yeah.
But the time sensors inside the sphere that she's in.
She was moving near C, relativity.
Yeah, was an intense time differential, and the cameras that they had in there were inactive for and recorded blank nothingness for that amount of time. So when I was pulled out.
Yeah, it looked to them like you were gone for maybe a second.
But it was
Star Trek: The Inner Light, where he lives the whole life in his head. How long have you gone? I was only about 20 minutes. What? Where's my wife? You weren't gone, sir. You never left the bridge. You were right here.
Yeah. Something like that.
Yeah. Essentially, you were taking.
That's cool. I dig shit like that. I dig that kind of.
He does on peace.
Nope.
I like that you caught that Cudgel has the ability to override Sakata's feel.
Well, yeah, that was evident.
Yep.
Because I had all of my clerical magic and my warlock magic.
Yep.
I didn't get jack shit.
Nope. There is a way you could have, but it would have been really funny to watch that play out.
Like once some convoluted chain.
No. See, the way I view yours is more, you learn how to summon them. There's no, like him, there's a deity behind
him.
And that imbued him.
When you're, what I look at is you're trying to come to an agreement with whatever you summon. And they don't have to agree to it.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much...
And that's an easy one to contact, because all that basically is a handshake. Phone call. Hey, you want to come out? I view yours as more, if you ever read the Discworld series, how they're playing the game with them all. Mm-hmm. The joke was with the main character, he was always super unlucky. He would fall into all sorts of random-ass circumstances. But Lady Luck favored his peace, so he always somehow got out of it in the most convoluted fucking way.
Yeah.
But she was always involved. So no matter what anyone did, there's a scene in the first book where the guy rolls a dice, and he gets a 6, and he's like, well, your piece is dead. She rolls and gets a 7 on a d6. And she looks at him and goes, guess I'm just lucky. Moves the piece out of the way, and he saves him. And they're like, the hell? She's like, you can't beat luck. Sorry. So, that's how I'm viewing your connection, is there's
that's
someone directly
really funny.
Involved with you.
That's really
you,
funny.
You're just making a phone call. Hey, buddy, can you show up?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I think those. I think all those calls are made as I'm leveling up, so all the calls would have been made by now, but yeah.
But it's still well, results in... Yeah, if you still, can't reach out to them to get to them,
they can't show up, yeah.
It's like Drew, why I had him roll every time was because he was finding it within himself to make it happen.
And if every time that happened, it was a chance.
Yes, it was a chance, whereas Cudgel was like, field or no field, just fucking carry out my will.
Yeah.
So.
This anti-magic field can't stop my right. Wham!
Yes. Chris would have been... Well, what is Chris? Is he just a sorcerer?
Is it a sorcerer or a wizard?
Probably. I know the twist with Chris here.
It's probably a wizard. Technically, it was his own. And he sold me his twist,
too. It is tougher.
Yeah.
It makes more sense to have two consoles and be on the Xbox Live.
Mm-hmm. So, Kirby, did you see that Elon Musk created a computer that can simulate the entire universe? Or it can run player unknown's battlegrounds on medium size?
See, I don't really care about frame rates, so I play on Ultra.
I play on Ultra. I fire my gun and then I wait 2 hours for the bullet to hit me and then I reload.
I see 5 frames a second, but those 5 frames are so crisp. We'll see.
I'm saying it's like when I'm just running around the map, which is what 95% of that game is just running simulator. It looks gorgeous. As soon as someone starts shooting at me, that's when I go at like 5 to FPS.
And you're gonna die anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, I got my view in. I'm good.
It's so pretty. It's like, oh, there it went.
Well, it's so pretty still. Oh, it's black screen. Fuck.
So you're saying I could probably, I don't need anything fancy.
He's in the bathroom.
He might have fallen in.
I've got a base.
Just while I play, when I play for real, I play on medium.
What's just gonna happen?
I can't stand it because I'm so shit.
Yeah, there's no doors on the stall.
How you doing?
I just have a base of all 1 HP.
Yeah.
Don't forget to scrub that thing.
But I might be.
Does that have any kind of special video card on it?
No.
What?
Probably won't play it then.
It's all in one.
Oh.
I don't know, just steal what Monica's planning to buy for the 5.
Okay. Lich guy, we got an in.
Nah, I got an idea.
An in?
Yeah.
With what deity? I can't say I'm up to date on your human or any other.
I present to you the Prophet of Cudgel.
Prophet, you said?
Of Cudgel, the Grand Master of Poison Sumac, the... What was that other
Grand Surveyor of all of
this. Grand Surveyor of all this and that.
Grand Surveyor, I put Master, okay. Surveyor? Okay.
Well, he's the Grand Master of Poison Sumac. That's where you got
that. Yeah, I got confused.
I like that. I'm going to have to edit the character sheet and put that
will.
On. Fuck, I'm going
to
do that.
Oh, yeah. There's less written down, don't worry.
No, that's true. That's fair. Well, fuck, I'm gonna have some.
Very well. If this being is capable of scrying and finding the target as it seems, I'd go for it.
I don't know how to scry.
Yeah, but this being, I mean, he can give him magic when no magic is available.
No. You need scrying ability. He wanders into a little hut, and by little, I mean.
Tiny?
The size of my kitchen.
Tiny you mean hut?
No, the size of tiny hut.
Tiny hut.
You got a scrying stone?
Told me stories of
tiny hut.
You
got a scrying stone? No. Scrying stone got lost in the swamp. Still got it.
Have you heard the stories of
Tiny Hut? It's ironic.
It is. He hands you a scroll. One scry ability. What? Oh, and I have this. Hold it up. Somebody said tiny hut. Here you go. Just scroll for tiny hut. One time use.
Oh, you just slammed your face across my leg. What the fuck, dog?
Come here.
Blondie.
She's
Lucy boy.
She's not gonna move.
No.
Blondie, come here.
I'm fine.
Try snapping, but.
Blondie! Yeah, no, she's got food. Jason stepped in puddles deeper getting here.
Measure to make her think I had food.
Who's puddles?
We weren't gonna talk about it in front of you, but.
Long story.
In high school, I knew a girl named nicknamed Puddles. Don't ask how she got the nickname.
Please
ask.
Do I need to pause the stream?
Okay, how did she get the nickname?
She got drunk as shit and pissed herself.
Nice.
Ah.
I was thinking it'd be a little more flattering than that.
Nope.
Wow.
That's still pretty
nope.
Nope.
We named a girl Shredder.
I've heard that story twice.
Named a girl what?
Shredder.
Shredder.
Fair enough.
Once that screen's off.
Yep.
I can kill the stream member.
No, that's good.
We ain't naming no names.
I think I've met one of her relatives.
You can tell stories or names.
Actually, I think I've met a few of her relatives.
They weren't part of the foot clan, were they?
No, I don't mess with feet.
Feet are for weird people.
Apparently, oh, Steph Curry has one. According to Mia Khalifa.
Oh.
Mia Khalifa.
Yeah.
Wow.
Dude, that right name and name.
Right, yeah, that's okay. Yeah, that's a celebrity.
Okay, so
we're close to celebrity.
Yeah.
Let's try for a paladin.
Alright, so he basically just wants us to go off this dude.
If they're in a
I don't care how
type.
You solve it. If you capture him, enslave him as you do your tiny...
No, I'm talking about my bank ever it is.
That's a personal thing. I'll let it slide because he seems to actually enjoy it. No, she seems to actually enjoy it.
It's kind of like foreplay for the little gnome.
It,
like whatever.
Fair enough.
Weird. I think
that's why we call her Puddles.
He has a sword.
She has legs, so she doesn't leave snail tracks. So there's that.
Okay, I can't you're saying that in character, you can have an inspiration point.
So there's that.
I walk back from taking a shit in the forest. What the fuck happened?
Did you just defecate in my forest?
Yes, I did.
Did you bury it? Hit that one.
Storm whip!
I had to go!
I follow protocol!
I didn't want to miss the story!
God.
No, I'm pretty sure defecating in someone else's forest is pretty mean.
At
all
least
bury
it. I don't want the foxes stepping in it.
They're fine. They're foxes.
Ernest does not look where he is going. He's too preoccupied.
Well, he's an idiot.
Shorty.
Then I agree with that, but I can't uphold him stepping in
What do you think?
Go bury it and get your killing shoes on.
Okay. I walk back into the forest.
Okay.
Sat with my head hanging down.
You can always roll a perception check to see if you hear what's going on.
No, I feel like I was far away. I needed a break from them.
Okay. he carries a sword.
Did you use leaf or smooth rock?
Sword. Don't use it. It is cursed.
Describe
the life of. I don't know how he got it.
It's a
my butt really scratches.
Skitches. Don't like the dog.
We'll worry about that when we get to it.
You obviously know where to find it.
I almost took a
Do
drink.
Do this for me.
I was like this. I was like this far.
I will call it even. I will tell him to send whoever he needs to go wherever.
Well, we have an accord.
Excellent.
I come back. I was like, fuck, I stepped in shit. Someone else in your force is not burying it.
Where did you find this?
We can't get rid of it. It's a bad thing.
It just
a big
out.
Hole near Celestia.
Oh, that thing? I hear no one survived.
Oh, that's a place. I thought it was a nickname.
Hey, guys,
oh,
that's not even bad right here.
No, that's good. Oh, the droid.
Do it, Master.
I'm glad you survived.
I like it now.
Although I believe we have there is much to discuss about
Hit me, Master.
Of a village.
So that's punishment to not hit you.
It was destroyed.
I am aware.
Why?
Solve this for me and we may talk about it. He walks into his tiny hut.
Oh, I really hope we don't that one. Little cliffhangers.
Let's head back to the boat.
Alright.
So what do we need to scribe for this guy?
Right now.
That was
Make it so.
But very well. As you use the scroll glows and dissipates.
Okay. I cast Bless on myself.
Okay.
First.
Very well. So you can have advantage, or what is it, plus four, yeah.
No. Plus whatever that default is, 27.
Alright.
Plus 4,000.
Yeah. Alright. And as you are, does Bless give you advantage or does it just give you the plus, the
d4? Just
d4. D4 to roll.
Okay. Then here's what we'll do. As it crashes, I have to open everything again. I'm trying to remember, because we looked up Scry once before. There we go. So it's the save modifier for Ent. You've heard of the targets, so you get plus 5 to it.
Yay, it's crying.
Do not have a possession of garment. So you got a plus 5, which is bad.
So the lower is better, apparently. You know what?
What was that for his roll or his?
Let's see.
My roll?
His roll is to block it.
Yeah, it's...
Cudgel's roll is to do it.
I think it's for my roll then, yeah.
Biggie heels?
Biggie heels. Biggie.
Biggie. Biggie Smalls.
Representing the East Coast. Scrying, here we go.
Peace looks good.
Alright, so for you, because you have a connection.
Just about to get into it too.
It was nothing.
2d4. Oh, throw an extra d4 in on your modifier to add, well, minus. As long as your number, we'll take it as long as your number beats my number. You get it. I'm just modifying it because I don't feel like adding all this stuff.
Okay. Yep. You ready?
Yep.
I've heard like a little bit of it, but I haven't like.
So I'm all Willy Wonka. This time it won't go.
Are you ready for this?
Go for it.
22.
Good, because I got a 19. I was like, shit, I set him up for failure.
Clutch. Forever clutch.
Yeah.
I don't know why that natural
quality. That's the new
Clutchel.
Targaryen title.
He's now
title.
B Clutch.
Forever Clutch.
Forever Clutch. Okay. So,
we should now call him Biggie Clutch.
Alright. So, your big heel's still right?
Yeah.
Biggie Clutch.
Forever Clutch. That's my title.
Was Forever Clutch. It's going in the notes.
God is writing a book on us.
Prophet? Yep. Of... Is it Prophet of Cudgel? Alright.
Yeah. Broken Bones. They'll be fine next season.
Ooh. Aaron Rodgers giving J.J. Watt ice cream for him.
As Forrest Gump. Lieutenant Watt!
Ice cream! Where'd he go? He got sent home.
But they ain't got no legs.
Bubba was going to run a shrimp boat. But then Bubba died right there in Vietnam.
Yeah.
If somebody's voicing cooked shrimp, you boil shrimp, you mash shrimp, you...
It goes on for 20 minutes.
Fry shrimp, you...
And that's about all the ways you can do shrimp.
That went on for about 2 weeks.
Yeah. That's all the ways you can cook shrimp.
Okay.
Yeah. Alright, so.
I'm scared to think what you're scribbling.
Just notes on what you've done. I also did put, if you want to come read it, Forever Clutch, if you can read my handwriting.
Read what?
Yeah, that's what I meant. Hieroglyphs, pictograms,
Dr. Scratches.
Code.
Dr. Scratches.
I was never going to be a doctor.
Alright. You don't have to be a doctor, you just have to write one. Like one.
Alright, where are you at?
So, all where right. is he?
So, as you're done, you commence to scribe. Scroll flies up as you're holding it, turns into pure light, shoots up into the air off the boat, your eyes turn into bright white lights, you collapse for a minute, you see...
I hate catching him.
Well, he's dead, throw him off the boat.
You thanks, you bunch of bitches.
Yep. You see, from what you can tell, multiple ships connected together. Driftwood.
Driftwood.
Yep. Do with this information as you please.
All right.
Hightail to Driftwood.
Go back to the extremely large lemon shop.
So
we're going plaid.
Do we have a heading?
Yeah. Where the fuck are we?
You are currently where it says B on the map.
Yeah,
so
we're there. So
south,
south, southwest.
Aye, aye.
So let's see. Minor illusion. That's a cantrip. Fuck, that's not.
You have.
Isn't that like where I got my ship?
And you also got weapons from Grab Keep and a couple from Driftwood.
So I should have like friends there.
You do.
It should be where you got your giant sniper rifle, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's where you retrieved your sniper rifle from.
We need to make a backstory.
Which we haven't used yet.
Backstory on what?
I'm gonna find my friends there.
Okay.
Because surely I know people that know things.
Roll a d10.
So, in an attempt to keep this
10 connections. Regards to various other pirating groups, courier groups, quote-unquote, things such as that, that you are familiar with. They are regulars, if you will. They don't necessarily live there, but they go there.
We need to have
those are my people.
Online
I know how to
network. Face line.
Now, I was trying to think of a way that we could keep this big slab of rock, you know, i.e. the boat that we're on, from looking quite like a...
Oh, we can... No. When I go there, I put it in the water. They don't... You can't tell the difference.
Yeah, we'll just want to wait for it to show up there.
Yeah. Okay.
Was how I don't want everyone to, like... Well, you know. I think by now, just about everyone has heard, but...
You know,
save the surprise for later.
Here
we can
roll
in.
Roll against me for how many people know.
For
roll what?
D20. This is the place where we got the quest to go
cocked.
Destroy the first one.
It could be 5 or it could be 18.
Sounds like 18. Plus 5.
How about 16?
Alright. So.
But yeah, but I had Bless on him, so.
Okay.
So 4. It turns out it's 20.
Okay.
So 20 people know?
You beat my roll. So, at this point, who you've spoken to on the boat know, the only real direct people who will tell who on this continent know are people who work the Giant Sunfire Forum, and the, like, 4 hospital workers.
Yeah, right now, it's kind of old wives' tale status at this point,
right? It's urban legend.
Yeah.
No one can prove it.
So when I float in, they'll just be like, oh, that was...
A friend of a friend knows
about
the
fucking lucky talking himself up again.
Yeah.
Flying ship.
Yeah, a friend of a friend knew about a flying boat.
Somebody later.
All right, so
a friend heard you can have a boat fly. You're fucking crazy, dude.
I mean,
but I heard it.
I seen it.
Water
like I seen it.
I seen it.
I seen it fly. I was on that first ship you destroyed of the ladies' fleet.
You smoking that crack again? Oh, you don't smoke crack. You inject the marijuanas, damn it.
I'll smoke crap.
That's how Taylor Swift died.
Wow.
I heard you detected 10 marijuanas.
Directly injected 10 marijuanas. Alright, so what are y'all doing? Nuts.
Look like what I just built with all the sand that fell out of your vagina. I saved that for somebody later.
Yeah.
Yeah. That boys and girls, why you don't do it on a beach.
Well, yeah, remember
depends
that.
Depends how much lube you have.
And how rocky it is.
I'm going to fly down there as fast as possible. Once we get about 50 miles out, I'm going to put it in the water.
Okay. So, as usual, your boat enters the water. And how much have you told your crew about what you're doing?
The people that weren't with us?
Yeah.
I told Claire everything and that's it.
Okay.
It's not their business.
Claire is going to bring up the fact that... Do you know who's protecting him?
Do you?
No,
so everybody's on the roll hating because...
I mean, it's a god, but... That's no biggie.
They just had their ordinary
night. Captain Luggy, sweetheart.
Just let me ask around. I'm a little concerned if it can...
Comments
from a glitch. Oh, it just makes me think of ICP whenever I see pictures of him.
I know people there. I can ask some friends. I'm sure you've got people everywhere.
It concerns me because I don't think it's a god.
Oh, so it should be easier.
No,
than
I mean, so you're with me on that.
I mean, god, I was, you know, I was playing big. I was actually scared of shit. But if it's not a god, we got this.
Higher devil.
It's fine.
Oh.
That's fine.
I'm glad you're...
Someone that might be interested
confident.
In me?
Prophet.
Someone that might already know who I am?
That's what I'm afraid of. Let me look at it. I'll do what I can while you...
We're good.
I'll be in my bunk.
Okay, Jane.
Remember those hats?
Yes.
Alright, so as you all approach Driftwood, the usual lack of any form of merchant marine or anyone to help you dock is find an open slip and hope it fits.
No, we just sit outside one and just, like, sit there and wait. Someone will be here in just a minute. 3 hours later, they're on the way.
Hold on, guys.
I've been here before. They know me.
We got this. Regardless of whether they know you, they don't have a form of government, remember.
Can you teleport objects? Because I'm thinking we might need to teleport some planks away from the hull of a couple of boats.
That boat's taking my slip.
I can teleport objects I've marked with a sapphire to my location.
Very well.
But I need a...
Don't you have a water snake?
It's a whole certain spell.
You got a water snake.
sure.
Touch.
Can swim.
Yeah, okay.
But, actual teleportation, I might be able to do something with actual teleportation.
No, that's right.
Okay. So what are y'all doing as you approach?
Can I find an open slip?
Oh, yeah, that's easy.
Ah.
The whole thing's made of boats, so
yeah.
Pull on that.
I pull in, look for any familiar faces. That's what I am.
Alright, well, as you walk off, as you dock, somebody walks up. Oi! You!
Hola, mi amigo!
Back, are you?
You know it.
Welcome back. You gonna be over at the Salty Plank later?
I'm a little bit everywhere, but yeah, definitely there.
Alright. We'll be waiting for you. John's in town too.
Definitely there.
Don't know where Caleb is, but hey, I do what I can.
Do I need to be writing these names down?
Make sure you put like grip when you put the name down. So you know where they're from.
Yep.
See, he knows because he's taken notes twice.
Oh, me? Yeah.
Check twice, check once.
So you've taken notes twice in your lifetime? That's pretty solid.
That's how he graduated from Warhill.
Ooh. Dang.
I thought he just showed up.
Oh, so you took the hard route.
Yeah. It wasn't advanced diploma.
It wasn't advanced diploma.
So. I ended up with an advanced diploma and a governor's seal I didn't earn. They sent it with the diploma.
I had enough.
I just took it and I was like.
With block scheduling, you get enough credits for an advanced diploma by your
what's it like
winter or
year,
junior year?
Winter, yeah. If you take the correct classes.
Yeah.
I knew people who took like one.
But I also
language, had one, the out. Number one on foreign language number one.
So
and it's like that doesn't.
I mix it up. I took
you see this
I took two easy cakes and two classes.
I was pissed. I had 6 years of Spanish going into WJCC.
They didn't take it.
They didn't take it at all. That's bullshit. Because that was like
you should have yelled at them in Spanish.
Oh. At that point in my life, I could have, because that's all they taught at the Catholic school. I was like,
he's
that was your foreign language, or you took trip.
I mean,
you must learn it in Spanish in case you visit the Spain and see the Pope.
Well, we had, our Spanish teacher was from Spain, so, like, from, like, second grade onward, it was fully in Spanish. Like, you didn't do anything if it wasn't in Spanish. All right, and the guy looks at you. All right, nice to see you again, Captain.
Howdy.
Hey, just so you know, his name is Connor.
How you doing, Connor?
Doing good. Did a shipment run between Archchild and Witherwood. Don't know what they want with that stupid bark, but hey. It's delivers.
I wonder how they're doing. We don't have any more scries.
He looks at you and goes, No, I know what you're talking about. Let's talk about a boat later.
Okay, cool.
They were wondering where you went.
Wait, are they done already?
No, was it a month or was it a week?
It was supposed to be 2 weeks, and it's been like a week. So they should be like there by now.
Yeah, okay. Fair enough. I forgot how long I gave you.
Yeah.
I'm glad you wrote that down.
Surprisingly enough, I didn't write it down. I just remember. I get my fancy armor in 2 weeks.
There you go.
Unfortunately, game time is very slow. In game time is very slow.
Just as you go off right in time, so I want to pick it up.
Well, it's been, here you go. You guys are right. It's been 4 days. Game time.
So
it's one of those days you all work through.
A week and a half.
You guys do great videos.
Connor, you heard or seen anything about a powerful paladin, probably a evilish type fella, commanding an army?
The dude who claims he's in charge of some fucking Armenian dead or some crap.
They figure
he's talking out his ass. He's got some pretty little sword and a little bit of armor. He claims he's some high leader or something.
He's definitely talking out his ass. Do you know where he is?
Oh yeah, last time he was over the Salty Plank about an hour ago.
Okay.
Doesn't have any money. Tries to get people buying drinks. Stumbles around. I don't know how he got here.
Yeah. What kind of leader of a huge undead army does that sound like?
Yeah. What he's doing out here on the water.
Yeah,
undead can't swim. No.
Yeah.
He says he came out of Stanlow, caught a ride with John. That's all I know.
You know, actually, he's a pirate who robbed a bunch of people in Florham.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Loser.
Yeah.
How's it keep coming
out?
Florham's only a few courses of lettuce. Because
he keeps rocking.
I mean, Eternia likes to give a shit for being illegal, even though they don't own the damn seas.
They're just jealous that they're not private and entrepreneurs as such as ourselves.
Yeah. Also jealous of the fact our navy's larger than them.
Yeah.
They were never good at that kind of thing.
All right, well, I'll see you over there. I'll be waiting.
Appreciate it. Have a good one.
Find that paladin of yours, if you can call him that. I call him the drunker. I'm trying to get the sword.
Cool. I'll remember that.
All right, what do you do? He wanders off. Don't sit on my heart. I'll just switch the chair.
Welcome to Driftwood.
Might as well.
Yeah.
You guys want to work or play?
Honey, I'm home.
It is created out of multiple, I guess the best thing, water world.
Yeah.
The all various ships chained
together.
That's
cool.
That's what it is, only they're mostly wooden. There's
technically the Black Rock is now Driftwood.
Yep. They're
but
all connected. They're
my crew knows not let anybody go.
At the core, there is one large ship. It appears to have been an oversized sailing vessel at one point. It's been turned mostly into the core.
Like a monster whaler or something?
Yeah, something ginormous. And it was now turned into where there is a council. They are the crew who stuck around the most. There is a form of government here, if you call it that. It's more like a mutual beneficiary agreement. You know, hey, Eternity has sent 6 ships to take us over. What should we do? Kill them?
Yeah.
Agreed. So.
A few times the pirate lords agree on something.
Yes, and very rarely does anything get done. Eternia views it as a lawless zone. Florum views it as a floating piece of wood, for lack of a better term.
Would you say the leadership system is basically kind of like that with the pirate lords?
Yeah, that's the closest I can give you.
I'm not one of them yet, though, am I?
No, but you are well regarded at the moment, as Connor was one for a while. He stepped down because he wanted to actually make money.
Yeah.
So he had been involved, as you would know, because he's spoken of it.
I refused it because I didn't want to be tied down to one spot.
Connor was for a couple of years in Walker Lab. He's a mentioned.
Wise dude.
And as he... Government. The council generally avoids him for that reason. Because he could return to that position. If he wanted.
So if I need something, I could go through him to pull some weight.
Yeah.
Okay.
They generally ignore him. He does what he wants.
That's
a now, good why, you're not sure. Anybody else with their backstories? I figure most of y'all are well established on con. Or didn't anyone travel? Did you?
They're all with me. We haven't left the boat yet. Well,
no.
We haven't left the dock.
Okay. Well, what are y'all doing?
I'm saying, welcome to my town. You want to work? You want to play?
Wow. I get my sweet tea. Let's
you
play.
Want a bit of both?
Yeah, I think so.
All right. We're going to go get some drinks at one of my favorite bars in the world.
And the salty blank.
The sandpaper.
Yeah.
Please be awesome.
Sand bar.
Please be awesome.
Please be a good day.
Well, which one are you going to? The sand bar or salty blank? Bar is in quotations. Please note that.
The salty plank.
Okay.
The plank is also in quotations.
As you walk in, there are various people. You see some actual Eternian colors. There is a ship dock there, but they don't appear to be doing much. You see some brightly colored girls from Florin wandering around, delivering drinks, doing various items. How they got there, no clue. There's no Florin vessel.
Away from home.
Yeah, no Florin vessel docked at the moment that you can see. It is a giant sphere of floating chest. There is a bar made out of a carved, it looks to be a mermaid at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
Plank put on top of it.
Is there open space to stand at the bar?
Oh, yeah.
That's where I'm going.
Spaces.
I'm saying hi to my friend, the bartender, whose name is
Caleb.
Alright.
Yes, this is his boat that is currently acting as the bar.
That's pretty cool.
Come lucky! You're back?
Yeah, just, you know, visiting the old stomping grounds for a little while.
Did you meet my brother? His brother is Connor.
Yep, he welcomed us in.
Excellent, excellent.
Yeah, it's always good to see y'all.
Yeah, had to do something with our lives. Which what brings you back around here?
You've chosen a noble course.
Alcohol is always a noble course.
Yes, it is.
Your usual?
Yeah, drinks for me and my friends.
I like a sweet tea, please.
He looks right at all of y'all. Oh, a couple of you are no... Leans over the bar. Ah, oh, you're rather short. What are you having?
I just hear...
Sweet tea, please.
Okay. Sweet tea. It must be from the north. Reaches down. Case about this big.
There you go.
Thank you. Make sure it's not the same thing as the last time.
Chugs it.
No. Okay, then.
Aren't you gonna miss that?
Huh?
Aren't you gonna miss that?
No. I'm not even gonna take the joke. I don't view it as a joke.
Or he's gonna call you once a month and just
bang. He's actually gonna send me an email. If
he ever sends you an empty jar, do not
open it. Damn it!
You know, this is why.
Why is it? Oh my god!
Something better than an empty jar.
Empty Folgers can?
Metal Folgers can.
Yo, there it is.
This is doing it to my brother.
It looks cool in that. Oh my god!
I'm curious to
Yes, it does.
Alright,
I don't know what they're talking
Death
about.
Death in a can.
Right, so we're already like five beers deep in
the Yeah, obviously.
Alright, we'll see. Constitution checks from everyone.
Even the sweet tea?
Even the sweet tea.
Oh, it's very sweet tea here.
Sweet is what they call alcohol. 16.
13.
16. Jeremy?
18.
13.
Modified 21.
You're fine.
12.
Modified 21.
You're buzzed. You're buzzed. You're 13?
Yeah.
You're buzzed. You're doing okay. You're doing okay.
For once. Right,
it has an effect on me?
Actually, what is your character's background?
I'm a robot.
Oh, there you go. You forgot about that.
It cleans his house.
Well, I forgot about the one time we did get him drunk because he asked for something that would get him drunk.
Yeah, yeah. Only a robot can get him drunk.
And it works. Yeah. So, yeah, you're fine. Yeah. I shouldn't have asked for you. Alright, so what are y'all doing now that you're all comfortably intoxicated and or enjoying yourself as Drew is?
I would like to see
would
if
you like
I...
another, guys?
So, like, I'd like to see if I see any paladin-looking guys with a little sword.
We get right, too much grease gun.
Yeah.
I look around and see if there's anyone with a paladin.
It's in the knife bar.
That's a 20.
Yeah.
That 20?
Yep.
Yeah.
Fucking, okay.
No, he rolled it.
Alright, you can see a guy looking, brooding over in a corner. By brooding, I mean in the most intense sense.
Can I go behind the bar and put on like a little apron thing and go over to him?
Oh, well. Oil slick. Defense.
Fine. Finish your description before I go over and walk to him. Gosh.
Thank you.
Like the game should go. I get too excited. I'm sorry.
Fine. Calm down. There's a guy sitting in the corner brooding. He appears to have some kind of armor on. It is not well kept, for lack of a better term. There's a sword sticking off his back. It appears to have the way he's been sitting. It has worked its way out of half out of its sheath and leaning against the wall. He appears to be trying to observe the situation, but not doing a very good job. He is either uninterested or well drunk. You can't tell from the other.
So, okay.
As the way he's sitting is kind of like
exactly.
I am now with
he's
his
not good.
We need that sword. Take him a drink.
We need to get the sword?
We need that sword. That's
you
what
you will make it. So
that's what Bart wants.
Okay. All right. So what are you gonna do?
He's about to die.
I go behind the bar. Don't you guys better freaking be ready. Who's drunk here?
Before you go
drunk?
Over. Before you go over, I touch you on the shoulder. Give you a blessing.
You're my favorite, man. You're my favorite.
I'm keeping a close watch.
So wait, who's drunk? Is
I'm
it Kudzu when these two are drunk?
Those two are the only two drunk. Irma is buzzed.
Who's drunk? I'm buzzed.
You're buzzed.
Oh, you're buzzed.
You're buzzed.
Okay.
You're fine.
Yeah.
Okay, he's fine.
Okay, good. You?
And, I'm keeping an eye on
him. He is completely untouched.
I lean over
unless
to you.
Unless he asks for
just
a drink
keep an eye
for himself,
on
him,
right?
That he wants, yeah.
I'm keeping an
eye
on
him. I'm
going
to
try to get the sword. Whatever.
What's your name? Who are you? You're with our party?
Yeah.
Look, do whatever you need to. I don't care. All right?
Just don't let him die.
So I go behind the counter and dress like one of the four maids.
Oi, short one, what are you doing?
I'm trying to indulge her. Just let her have her fun.
Look,
it's fine. You got my
money. I'm not even asking for money. I'll take orders or whatever. I'm not even asking for money.
What are you looking for? As long as you don't touch my drinks, you're fine.
Okay, I'll give the orders to you and then.
Listen, what are you trying to do?
How well do you know him? Can I tell him what's going on?
Oh, this
these
is my
three,
boy.
These three are three good
like,
friends.
Yeah.
Okay, are they like good friends?
Oh, yeah.
We're trying to get that man in the corner's sword.
Why are you trying to steal his sword? It's an ugly ass sword.
That's why.
Someone needs it,
right?
Well, they have poor taste.
You know.
Let me know what you need. I'll help out.
Okay.
I think we need to get that guy
get
drunk.
Get one of your...
What, 100 gold or something?
Yeah, more like
anyway.
10 times that.
I wasn't going to go there, but fine. If you're going to bring that in.
Jesus Christ.
I didn't mean to sink.
I thought you guys were butts.
I didn't mean to sink his ship. Okay? It was a rock there. It came out of nowhere.
It just appeared out of nowhere.
What's your most alcoholic drink?
Ting, he reaches down. Ting brings out blood wine. Ting, there you go.
Ah, yes.
Ting.
Got this in. Someone said they got it from over in Eternia. Photograph.
How deep is that fellow already?
Oh, he's been here for 4 days.
Just there? Like in here?
In this room.
Jesus.
He didn't sleep.
Yeah, you're right.
He didn't sleep. I don't know what he's been doing. He's been trying to commune with something. Occasionally he'll ask me for some odd little bits, spices and shit. He pays well. Creates some little ritual and it never works.
What spices?
Don't know everything about this guy,
actually,
but what I do know, bad juju. Very bad juju.
You're buzzed.
I'm playing drunk.
Well, bad juju, I believe it. You were asking
Arcana
about spices.
16, yeah.
You would know from the spices that he's asking you is to attempt to commune with some form of devil or demon.
Very well.
Thyme, a little bit of oregano. He crushes it up, mixes it with some salt, forms a pentagram, and then does some kind of chant. I can't repeat the chant. My tongue doesn't click.
Don't we just use my mage hand to grab the sword?
You would know specifically that it is for one of the devil.
It's got to have tricks.
You don't know the name, as it's always been redacted from every book you've read.
Of course.
Like, as in, ripped out, redacted.
Shit. That's really just going to be vibes of book I was just reading.
What book were you reading?
The Mistborn series, there's an evil being that removes all text that he doesn't want.
That's funny.
Yeah,
all right.
I haven't read that at all, so. But
yeah. All right, just keep an eye on me.
Sounds like a really
I'll try to get him drunk, right?
You're trying to get him drunk? He's already drunk.
I'm trying to get him drunk enough that I can take his sword without him being able
drunk
to.
Drunk
Yeah.
I'll feed him 2 drinks of that, say it was on the house or from one of the cute little girls I got working.
Alright.
There you go.
She should take it.
Appreciate it.
I take 2.
You can knock half that that price off.
After that, you have as many bottles as you want.
Alright. I grab a bottle and I head over to him.
Alright, so you grab a glass, the bottle, and the serving tray.
Yeah.
Walk over. Okay. Yeah. You walk up to him.
Can you see over the table?
Against? Huh?
Can you see over the table?
That's a good question. Actually, roll for that.
8.
Yeah, you can. I got another nat 1. It's either a 20 or a 1. I have no idea why.
You're doing good.
Yeah.
Keep it up, big shot.
Thank you. Okay. Just noting some what's going on with them.
You're good.
Probably.
That's the music I need.
You didn't want to open another program?
Are you about to strip for this guy?
No. I'm slower at typing, but I never actually did have to take typing in school.
Yeah, they called it keyboarding.
See, I never had to take keyboarding. I was right before it was mandatory. And when I got to high school, it still wasn't mandatory. They tried to put me in the class DIY, which was keyboarding.
No.
But my mom was like, if you put him in there, he will just fuck with your computers. He'll be bored. No.
Your mom was a good person to somebody.
If only there were more of her.
I wrote 27 on my page, right. I have no idea.
As you approach with the glass of blood wine that you all probably ended up delivering secondhand somehow, and the goblet to carry it, you approach, and the paladin sitting in the corner half asleep snarls and looks at you. Shorter servant girl is that, huh? Who sent this one?
You see that girl over there?
Yeah.
She caught an eye on you, and she was like...
For her, smart. Takes the whole bottle, uncorks it, and starts drinking it. You can take the glass. You can take the tray back in the glass.
Okay.
So he stops you. Hold on. Ask the bartender. I need a handful of leaves.
A handful of leaves?
Oak leaves.
Okay. I like to write it down. Alright.
Alright. Good.
As I'm about to turn,
he throws you a little small coin purse.
No, don't do that.
Roll for dexterity to see if he gets it, because you're holding a tray.
Twenty-one.
You catch it. Ting. What do you do? Walk away.
I open it.
Dexterity.
Okay. Wow. And
it was an athletics check to see.
I thought
you
it was dexterity.
You said dex, not athletics.
Yeah, no, I just did a jump.
And
athletics.
As I turn around, I drop.
Right?
No.
Plus 5, yeah. Unless it's proficient.
Is he proficient in athletics?
No.
Okay,
so
yeah,
I'm acrobatics, but...
12 plus 5.
17.
Yeah.
Not 21.
Yeah. Athletics would be lifting
it. You said dexterity, I didn't know
if
you
catching it.
Oh, yeah.
Not the saving throw.
Yeah, I thought it was dexterity.
Saving throw is when you're getting attacked by something.
Well, yeah, you're
sorry,
right.
I pulled the rocks out of my ass. Alright, so you caught it. That's all that matters.
It was a good roll, no matter what.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's fine. You open it?
Yeah, I open it and see what's inside.
3 platinum, 1 gold.
Your eyes wide.
You give me those. You give me those oak leaves. 4 more platinum.
And I
just work for this guy. And I can read his lips, by the way. So.
I know. I'm not hiding.
As I turn away, I drop my my tray.
Hey, be careful, short one.
It's okay. As I reach down, and then I come back up, I grab the sword out and I run.
You were at this level on him, like where my knee is.
Well, I assume it's like out, right?
No, it's up on his back.
Yeah, but I thought it's like it's still way over your head.
Oh,
really?
Yeah, it's
coming out of his.
You can just like crawl up his back.
Okay, no,
be like, what are you doing?
If he's sitting in this way, right? He's sitting this way. It's coming out
like
that.
He's sitting like I am, but his butt, the wall.
Oh,
it's
coming out this way.
No, I thought it was coming out that way.
No, no,
I thought it was. I thought it was enough.
No, it's half out of its sheath, but it's half out of its sheath.
Mission accomplished. Evac.
We're getting
out.
We're getting him drunk. I drop it. I just pick it up and.
Careful, Owen.
Sorry. All right. I think I'm drunk.
What are you doing?
Someone taller go. All
right.
I got this. Just sit down.
He wants some leaves. He wants some leaves.
Like, what kind of leaves?
He just said leaves.
Like the ones that we got?
Oak leaves.
No, but he's telling us. He just said leaves.
Yeah,
I was
just asking. Correct you.
Oak leaves.
Okay.
I really just heard leaves.
Let's give him some of these leaves.
That's. I mean, yeah.
You think the leaves?
Let's mix the drugs here. Get them real fucked
so,
up.
So, a couple oak leaves.
Although,
a couple
I don't think he's looking to smoke them.
Actually, you never did identify what those leaves were.
Yeah.
Sumac.
Sumac.
Look, he's
ooh,
drunk.
Who
is
it?
I was just trying to make an extra
sumac.
Back.
No.
You say no one rolled for what the leaves were. They just.
I'm just gonna. Yeah. We're gonna take our.
There was a variation of leaves too, so it could be different.
Well, the question.
Alright, Irmer.
You could just be like really dumb and try to bring him the leaves.
Just take them.
Like, these aren't the right kinds.
Just take
them
the leaves. Yeah.
I'm
22 Arcana on the leaves.
Roll for Arcana?
On the leaves.
They're leaves.
He's also doing something with them.
Well, you know they can be used in a various amount of rituals, depends on what he's going to do.
Like summoning a god?
Yeah,
you're basically going for, I want to use, what is gasoline used for? What vehicles are going? There's a list.
Yeah, okay. And it's too large to narrow down.
Exactly.
Okay.
What was your plan?
Just sit quiet. Just sit tight. I walk out of the bar, I summon a succubus, I walk back in, have the succubus go over and charm his ass.
Alright, so she walks up. As she approaches him,
he's gonna recognize.
Portal opens. She disintegrates.
Oh, I tried.
Send the bard. Don't even.
Whatever's in the bar, he says with a loud baritone.
Wait, what?
With a loud, he projects this voice.
No, yeah, before that, I missed.
That was a nice attempt. Try harder. You need to actually talk to me.
Well, I'm not walking close to him.
He leans back, and it is from what you can tell with your. Ritual summoning ability. Something pulled us back. It agreed to work with you. Something said, oh, whoa now!
Nope, not allowed.
Mine!
Stay away.
Yep.
Who do you serve?
Do you have a patron?
I don't serve anyone.
Okay, there you go. I take him back the leaves.
Who does your succubus serve? I mean, you get
I'd
on
like
loan from someone,
him.
Right?
I wouldn't mind visiting your ass, but it's a perfect
I mean,
trip.
Prime World, I just made deals with all these
people. I mean, I'll go with you the next time you go, but...
I've never went up there before.
I don't want to. It's too cold. I have mass power and favor with the planes to some of my people. It's not deals. The deals are with how I got the power. So, succubus, not...
So the deals are how you get power.
Are you feeling any of the similar vibes
coming
off this
deal?
Guy?
No, I make a deal with whoever the fuck wants to make a deal.
Oh, okay,
so
you're basically...
I don't pick a
so you're
person.
Basically,
like,
you don't have a patron or anything.
A whore for...
Whatever.
Yeah, all I care about is power. I don't give out my body, I give out my soul.
Kinky.
Wow.
Alright.
I'm gonna take him back to the leaves, try to get some money.
I look at Caleb while he's walking away. Alright. We gotta liberate the sword from that paladin dude. Bad juju. This is for the good of basically all driftwood, because that's not a good thing for him to be here.
Alright.
We're going to need some sort of diversion, or you're okay to just slaughter this dude right here.
Let's kill him here if my debt goes away.
Score. Nah. It must be a lot of money.
Everybody likes that debt over this guy's head.
Yeah, that's.
Me and my spouse.
Well, if he owes you this much, how much does his brother owe you?
I was glad you caught on that.
So what's going to happen is he's going to get the money from him to pay his brother.
Or we just do each other favors. Not Whoa. Like that.
Wow.
That's it, kill Basil.
Basil, you perv.
How about this?
Look, I've had a couple sweet teas, all right? You can't.
I'll talk to my brother and get your debt going.
I mean, I don't worry, you know, because...
Well, I know he doesn't actually.
Owing debts basically guarantees you work at some point in your life.
Well, he doesn't exactly call for money.
No,
I know he prefers getting deliveries of whatever
what?
You
I
have
mean,
in stock.
Do I?
No, there's that.
When was the last time I saw you? Years ago, man.
Yeah, there's
that.
And
you know, it's just I want to slay this guy, but the way he just kind of poofed that succubus makes me think he's hiding some power.
Right, you would know. He may not have done.
Oh, I would say
that
he probably didn't.
But he did.
The only thing I can think, maybe.
Whatever's watching his back, you think it could catch a bullet?
Not, just could completely.
Besides catching one to the dome.
Me and Connor may be able to work something to get him deep into the old engine room. And when he refers to the engine room, your character would know this is the deep bowels of the core ship.
Okay.
It's a little bit more private, less likely to be collateral damage, if you will.
You think I'm concerned about collateral?
The only thing that you should be concerned about is sinking into the ocean.
Yeah.
And if this fight gets ugly, it very well may. It won't to the core.
Yep.
Me and Connor may be able to get him down there.
Anyone have any better ideas?
Nope.
It's either that, or you try to find someone who can teleport him out of here. That's all I got. And I don't know anyone with that kind of magic.
Yeah, and even then, something's got this guy's back.
Yeah. I mean, I can't get him to leave.
I have a wish.
Well, there's that.
We're going to need to see what we're dealing against first.
Right.
I stand up long.
Did I come back with the money?
Okay.
This is what I'm
waiting for. Who are you?
It doesn't matter.
Watch out,
who are you,
sir?
Who are you? What?
Servant.
How the hell should I answer that question from some random... Are you female? I can't even tell.
Doesn't matter.
Out of game. Are you human? I don't remember.
Tiefling.
Tiefling.
Okay.
Demon child.
Purple skin, horns.
That explains a lot about your character.
Wow. Power whore.
He stands as he leans forward to step out. The sword falls back into its sheath.
Chief.
What are you, some minor deity's courier?
No. I know exactly what they're trying to summon, though.
What am I trying to summon, huh?
As far as I know, his name was never omitted in any books I've read.
Alright, you want to step outside and try to guess? Okay.
I don't know.
Roll a history check, and then we'll see.
I mean, the only thing he told me earlier was that all his names
was
omitted.
Nice.
18.
Yep.
Let's see,
nice.
What is this? This is clutch. 18 plus an 8, so that's going to be a 26.
Yeah, okay. Alright. We'll see how well you bungle this.
Bungle?
Yeah.
The homies are outside, steal their stuff.
Lock them out. Hold on, just flip.
I thought his sword was lower down, so...
And slowly start taking apart Gundam models.
Oh god, just move them. Shift them.
Did you do it quietly?
Yep.
Awesome.
That's fucking priceless.
This is a fuck you.
So, Critical Role... Grog jokingly was titled in one of, in Percy's town, the Gunslinger.
Okay.
He's the Baron. The Grog.
It's not
the grandpa of all of this and that.
That's awesome.
Yeah. I think there's something before that, but I always get lost at Pooba. It's like they used it.
He just went over and he looked up and I just started laughing.
You alright over there, Skippy? Yeah, I mean, because you work today, right? What time did you go in?
8.
Till when?
1.
Oh, 8 to 1, yeah.
Part-time hours.
Those days like that really wear me out, too.
I mean, just
that was 7, though.
I used to work those hours. It was a lot of weight training.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, so you had from 1 o'clock until 4 when your mother took you guys all to Starbucks and then Walmart to work out. So how many miles did you run today? Weird.
You put your Fitbit on.
You're going to get hurt.
You put your Fitbit on before you...
It's like two-a-days. You got to go start running before two-a-days start.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you're fucked.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I know you served the ultimate one.
So that's what you guys call it now. What did he remove his name from the ledger or some shit?
As far as I can see, it's always been magically removed. One black bar or a hole in the page.
He is a little vain like that. What do you want? What do you think you're gonna do? You should know, you and me, we're nothing to him.
No.
And I'm betting me versus one. What are you, some demon summoning? Monster. I bet I can carry it.
Why would I want to fight someone who I want to share power with?
Share power? He doesn't share power. What do you want?
Any way to rule the world.
What are you, some pop singer or song? You know what? You're the first person to actually talk to me. Pulls out a piece of paper. Writes down a location, throws it at you. Meet me there in what? There are no clocks in... Why are there no clocks in here? The guy, the bartender replies, Caleb. Boy, we're at sea. Why do you care about clocks?
You use the stars, mate.
Meet me there in like an hour or so. Alright, what do you do?
Stand up and walk away.
Alright.
I'm just going to walk straight out of the bar so he doesn't see me sit down with anybody.
Okay.
And I go give him his leaves.
You walk up to the living room.
Hey man, I heard you're looking for some leaves.
Can't do that. Cool. Fucking bag. Hey, you want some coffee?
Shut up, Tweet.
How did the Japanese people determine who's gay?
Alright, so you deliver the leaves.
Yeah, the leaves.
So you walk up. What are you? You just hold out the leaves? What do you do?
I'm your friend. With these leaves.
I'm your friend. I don't remember having a battle with his friend.
Well, now you do. Here are your leaves. You requested.
He reaches out, picks one up. How did you know they were oak leaves? Whatever. Grabs them. Tink. Hands you a little purse. Tink, that was supposed to be for the tiny... Tiny short one, but here you go.
Thank you. I'm out.
Alright, so you add 4 platinum and 1 and 2 gold to your cart, please.
You walk out the door, out the bar, back to the boat.
Yep.
Alright, what are the rest of you doing? That leaves you 3 and
Now I got a nice little buzz on. Alright, well, Caleb.
You said 4 platinum.
4 platinum, 1, 2 gold.
May still need your help later on, but it looks like we found a way to get him out of your hands for now.
Yeah, he leans over.
Oi, tell me what that paper said. That was one of yours that got the location, right?
The what?
That was one of yours that got the location, right?
What paper?
The one she got.
Oh.
I'm assuming you were paying attention right now.
No, I was drunk.
Oi, if you figure out where they're meeting, let me know.
Alright.
Of course you owe nothing.
Take for this round.
I owe nothing because I know nothing. Have a last drink. We're out.
All right. You go with
it? Give it a minute.
Okay. You just wait. All right. What about you, Jeremy? What are you doing?
I come and bring the leaves I had in my hand for the longest time, but he already
here you go. He's like,
yeah, I thought you sent your little robot friend already did this. Whatever. I don't need him for right now. Keep him. I might need him later.
Bitch. Yeah, like, not talking to you. I was like, my robot's a bitch. And I walk away.
Reprogram him. Wander him. Okay.
And then I leave.
But Johnny Five is alive.
So it leaves you, just you, Jason.
Hang out for 5 minutes.
Okay.
And just to see what he's doing, if anything's going on.
No, he's just kind of sitting there. You see him take the leaves and smash them up. That was about it. Like, kind of grind them together, hold them. You see red energy pour from his fists, and then it goes away. It appears as though it wasn't enough. As it started to glow, get brighter, and then stop.
Okay.
I didn't take them oak leaves.
But apparently that's what they were.
Well, you never investigated what
that's
they were.
That's true.
And you never investigated.
So I didn't know if they were oak leaves or not.
They probably were oak leaves.
Alright, what are y'all doing?
I'm heading out. Finish the drink. Set the tanker down and head out.
Alright. Y'all regroup on the boat?
Yeah. I just want to ask.
Go to the central location.
Okay.
Alright, so where are you meeting this guy?
Whatever location is on this ship.
Okay, so you put down a little note. It's denoted by ship name, location on that ship, and relative position up, down, relative deck number. It appears to be somewhere in a ship next to the courtship, which was the former whaling vessel that formed Grand Ship. From what you can tell, it appears to be in what would have been the cargo hold of that ship.
Yeah.
It's the best I can give you.
Based on the deck and the frame number?
Yep. That frame number, location, in the cluster. There's really no accurate coordinate system for this location. You just have to know each ship's name and how many decks they
all have. For any location on the same thing. Though.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do I have any crew that's like been with me for so long that they know this place?
Roll for it.
19.
You do.
How many people?
2.
Good. Send one person to go tell Caleb where we're meeting him.
Okay.
And I send someone else to go to where all the leaders are on the big ship in the middle and tell them that some shit's about to happen next door.
The former navigational contact.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hold on, why is one going to send to be sent going to go tell that bartender? Being I didn't know Caleb asked.
He's an old friend and he's gonna help.
Yeah, Claire comes back.
A little weird.
I'm a little worried about this.
Oh, which part, per se?
Who the paladin's got representing him?
Yeah, we don't know yet, so...
She is. I can't get an answer out of mine.
Well.
That means one of two things. Either no one's backing him, or one of the top guys is backing him.
Someone's definitely backing him.
Well, it's one of the top guys, and they won't answer me about that. I'm just a lowly little servant.
Oh, don't say that.
Have you read any books lately?
That's what they call me. You guys read any books? No, I'm serious. Is that what you asked? What kind of
book? Any books of the underworld.
No, I don't like to read literature about myself.
Do the top guys bleed?
I honestly don't know. You have to remember, when I was there, I was busy.
You will.
Bleeds with a color.
I guess I pull out my notebook that has the name of it in one location.
She closes it. Hands it back. I'll be back. Walks away.
Well, shit, that's not good.
Well, I'm just gonna chill here and two people run off.
Okay. So, the one who goes back and tells Caleb comes back with an affirmative of he'll be there. He'll have someone there. If not him. The second guy comes back. They want to talk to you.
Oh. Like, now?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll make my way there. Whoever wants to come along. Anybody want to meet the captains of this big ass ship?
Oh yeah.
Oi. The admirals, if you will.
Meh.
Okay. Oh yeah, I'm there.
Yep. No big deal. How long will it take?
It just shouldn't be more than a few minutes. it's only happened once before. It was a misunderstanding. But
it was only one cannonball, and it only sunk two ships.
Yeah.
Sorry.
They were just jealous of anything.
It was cool. It was probably the coolest thing they've seen in a while.
I mean, yeah. You've seen me day to day. You know that this stuff happens.
All right, so are you answering their summons?
Yeah.
All right, so as you move forward, you notice they're actually, you know, as you move further into the ship, the interactions become seedier. And the boats appear to not as fragmented.
Mm-hmm.
There aren't deck planks that are creaking and moving. It's all one stable platform. It appears to be old wood or stained from the elements.
Keep your hands on your money bags, people.
As you move through, you also notice that the general populace appears to be more seedier.
Scallywag?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
What are you showing pictures of?
This is all
true. What are you showing pictures of?
That reaction was good.
Okay.
They put the racing girl.
I see what.
Yeah.
I think that's some horsing around.
I'm just like, huh? That's funny. Oh, that's my father.
That's up under the jacket and everything.
All right, but as you approach, you finally approach the conning tower of the former whaling vessel. There are a couple of rough-looking guards standing by. They just motion you up. There are no uniform of any kind. It's just weapons. They're not even saluting. They're just...
I know.
Jesus.
Yep.
Oh, like it hurt. You were like... Right, yeah. I heard the noise.
At the top of the conning tower...
Kind
of
like an empty hollow duh. Yeah.
At the upper end of there, the conning tower, there are seven people standing around, just standing. Table in the middle. Map of driftwood on it, and a couple other maps you can see mixed in. They look at you. Captain Lucky.
I'm back.
I'm surprised.
I mean, I...
Your respect for this council is, well, it's better to say what respect.
Hey, you've asked me to do things and I've done them for you.
Eh, begrudgingly.
You don't offer much money.
Well, what's the fact that Connor owned you?
He came willingly when he asked.
Who owned him?
That is a false allegation and completely untrue. Fake news.
Well, but Connor is forgiving with his debts. I see you amassed. Who came? Who actually came with you?
I think all of us came.
All of you? Okay. Seeing as you've actually amassed a crew for once, and an actually respectable boat, not a dinghy with a sail on it.
I'll have you know,
this
is my crew for twice.
Twice? Okay.
I'm very prestigious now.
Jesus. He's supposed to spell rock hard, too.
Very well.
Settle down.
Yeah, right.
That's what you got for me.
Hard.
Well, your messenger brought word of demon-backed paladin on board?
Mm-hmm. See, I'm trying to be helpful here.
Now, what brings him here? If you're the one telling us, it worries us that it took this long for us to realize.
We're just here to take something that belongs to someone else from him. He has someone else's sword. We're trying to get that back. We don't know why he's here. I mean, I'm assuming he's here to get in touch with his inner godliness, whatever. He's been unable to do so.
That's a problem. I hear they have.
I think he's. Yeah, I think he's doing it here probably because, well, I still don't have any cops around or anything still.
Fair enough. That would explain the rash disappearance of random crew members.
See? Problem solver extraordinaire.
You keep giving yourself titles you haven't earned. Right.
He's earned it.
Who are you?
Fuck you.
You see a couple of claw weapons.
Hold on. Stay away. She bites. Stay away.
I imagine it's infectious from your hand. Look. They all put their weapons
back. Okay, just don't make eye contact.
Alright, this paladin then, if you can call him that. What's he taking people for? I thought paladins were like cops.
He's working for someone we think maybe a
he's fallen.
Very powerful god,
hard.
Maybe a fairy or a pixie. Could be a lot of things.
You got a plan? Okay, I hate to say this, especially this Connor's not around here. You got a plan to get him off this boat?
Yeah, kill him.
How?
I know, it's just foolproof.
Like,
as usual, you thought things through.
Yes. We spent several nights on the sand.
I don't understand these words you said. Carry on.
We're all gonna die.
But you're gonna live while you're doing it. Is that not the goal of life?
I can't believe you're living back.
It's just a quick visit, don't worry.
Yeah, I'll be gone by the end of the week.
Maybe. We'll be gone by the end of the day, maybe not in a fun way.
I'm getting that feeling that there may not be a driftwood by the end of the day if we fall through your plan.
I mean, we're trying to get them in an isolated area. If you have any ideas of, I mean, this is your spot, man.
He points to the map. You think you get into this boat? It's a cargo hauler, by the way. Is she all good?
Yeah, she's crawled through.
Okay. Points to a cargo hauler by the name of the Erie. Think you can get him here?
Of course I can.
Irma, think you can get him to meet you there?
I think so. Cargo.
How far away is it from where?
It was donated by Eternia.
Oh.
So
fuck those guys.
Yeah, we can check. You break the chains off it. It's all afloat. You can sink her. Do whatever you need to do.
Okay.
We'll take out driftwood.
I have a feeling we can sink a buddy.
Yeah, I hope you can too.
Just a little.
Claire.
I'll have you know I have zero experience in that.
There's what?
I have zero experience in sinking boats.
Okay, fair enough.
What do you call your boat falling out of the sky?
Shut them.
Falling out of the sky?
Bad teleportation.
High as fuck.
Really bad teleportation stuff.
You can teleport a boat?
Yeah,
well,
like I said, bad teleportation stuff.
Shoot, are those oak?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Now you're on my level. How far away is their boat from the spot?
Actually, it was
core?
Yeah.
I saw
him. Jason, 10 minutes.
What's he talking about?
If it were a straight line, it would be like.
Yeah, you are
on the southern.
You're like
on the southern. The boat is on the southwestern part, which is the least developed. Basically, it's a half circle. It's not complete yet. The area was put in that southwestern. I can draw you a map of the boat.
Oh, you're gonna have to draw. So I want a map of driftwood.
Okay.
I got Ashley good at 7-Eleven one time. Down one of the little aisles.
Excuse
I let
me,
him
everybody.
Go like loud, and I like took off the.
Still not as good as Warhol.
Like, people were looking like.
All right.
You guys really gotta print him something that will stand up.
I'll work
is the core. This is where you are now.
The same guy is gonna print your boat. He's gonna print my minifig.
So, the general design of it right now is like that. Quit taking my eraser, Drew. It's like that. The Erie
north
is right
south.
Here. Yep. North, south, east, west. The Erie is right here. They are developing this as where there's little dinghies and stuff adding around.
Where's the rock?
The rock
is shuffleboard?
Is over here. Fuck you!
God, the dog's got it!
Good. The black rock is right there. The salty plank is right here. And the other bar I mentioned is
you
here.
You say I can work up easily.
You do.
Okay.
At least I wasn't on camera. I feel better.
we have an hour?
You have roughly an hour to meet him there.
Okay.
It is a quick 15-minute walk to the Erie, just due to the fact that it's closer in because that area isn't as developed. It was previously used as a harbor, as you would know from your time there, but it's been determined that they need to expand outward a little bit more just because of the fact that it's actually turning into a population center. Because it's also one of the few midway points between the two continents. So most ships make a stop there.
Okay.
Whether they want to or not.
I've got an idea, but all my ideas are dependent upon one thing.
All right,
can
let's hear
Irma off. Get Dude to follow her to that boat?
I'll do my best.
Yeah, we're screwed. I didn't say that out loud.
Not like I did. I had to guide us past like five group of guards.
Yeah. Oh man. I'll tell you what I'm thinking. The boat that they want us to get on, what does the boat have a name?
What about the one they're trying to get you to? The Eerie.
The Eerie, that's right. It floats. It works. It's a boat, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't float. No,
it's a seaworthy vessel.
So I'm trying to think, do we want to get a small crew on there and have them sail it out and somehow restrain him while that's happening? Is it seaworthy enough that it can be sailed, or would it... I think I'm going to be better off if we take the Black Rock out here and tie a rope to it to tow it out.
Okay.
Because at least the Black Rock can move pretty fucking fast. It's magically propelled.
All right.
It's magically delicious.
Yep.
He looks at you guys. Okay, so the Eerie floats. It's a just recently decommissioned attorney in cargo hall.
I didn't mention the Black Rock is magic at all.
Yeah, I know. I'm assuming at this point you asked him, is it seaworthy?
Yeah.
Looks at you. Yeah, the Eerie is completely seaworthy. It's currently floating. Because only the ships surrounding the core aren't seaworthy anymore. Because that's just because of the fact that they have no rudders. We've taken those off.
They have a new purpose in life.
Yes. Is it now? Okay. Roll a history check for me. Just a generic history check.
That's not going to be very good. Yeah, that's a 6.
Okay, then you would not know the information. All right, have any other of you been to Driftwood before?
I mean, besides the last time we were here?
Besides the last time. Okay.
No. I mean, I could have, maybe.
That's your backstory.
Yeah.
Do they have sheep?
No.
Then nope, I wasn't ever there.
At least he has a singular way of determining it.
I really think I might have been there because I was trying to escape from...
If you believe that, roll for history then.
I mean, I was just thinking because I'm trying
to
escape.
It's also kind of a, what are they called? Human trafficking hub?
Yeah.
Oh, so I probably...
Okay, then roll for it.
I
it worries me that that's how
problem,
we determined
brother,
it.
Now.
Oh, it's funny. I didn't roll well anyway. So
of course.
I imagine I probably just stayed on that first
option. I had to make money
somehow.
For
I got a solid 8.
That sounded so fun.
Okay. All right, Will. You're the last one if you want to roll.
Excuse me.
No, I imagine I just probably stayed on the first shot. My first.
Okay.
Traffic.
2 years of travel.
Yeah.
All right, then he looks at you and goes, listen, well, as you would probably know, Captain, the core can be disconnected if need be. The inner ships are fire ships, if you will. They're usually kept with buckets of water in them to prevent fires from spreading. So if you have to take the fight to them, we've thought of that. Especially after Attorney attacked the first 2 times.
So I'm just...
2 times.
I'm confident that we can get them on that boat. I'm extremely confident that we can get them on that boat. I'm just worried that, you know... He might have a lot of juice, and we won't be able to get far away fast enough before he can do some damage to the city.
I don't know how to get him out. We haven't dealt with him enough.
Yeah.
I don't know what he wants. I don't even know why he's here. We didn't even know he was here.
He's working for some big bad...
Demon, devil, what? God? Demigod? Retired god?
Any ideas?
Demon.
Big bad demon.
They're ugly when they get pissed. Well, how about you take a day and think on it? See what intel you can gather. We'll see what we can do.
Good. So I can say this. Irma, go have some fun. Get on his good side. Enjoy yourself. All those things I'm sure you've done at some point before in your life.
Maybe? Let's
say yes. Ew. Give him to trust you so that tomorrow when you'd be like, hey, let's go steal a boat. Let's just take him. Just take him to the boat. Yeah, we'll work on it, obviously. But for now, go meet him.
We'll coach you.
Okay.
Alright. She puts in the earpiece and we tell her everything she needs to say.
Alright, so this is a long rest. It is 9:50. I think we'll just call it quits.
This group doesn't have earpieces.
Nope.
Yeah. We do now.
Best we can do is
we can't just
message.
Rewrite the meta.
Yes, we can.
That's probably a breaking point. All right.